So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna take number 9, for example, and see how we can tell, without too much difficulty, that the slope of this line would be -4/5, the y-intercept is gonna be -2. But I'm going to talk about the basics of graphs yet again. Because, well, honestly, I'm absolutely 100% sure for most of you it's because you've heard me say the basics of graphs before, but did not make the decision to assign some importance to it in your mind. Your brain said, don't really need to listen to this. Eventually, some shortcut's going to come along, something you can memorize, some kind of a trick that'll make all that learning unnecessary. And I can just know the shortcut and just do the shortcut. The problem is, very few of you remember the shortcut without knowing stuff about graph basics. Okay? So let's go through the graph basics again. Let's graph a graph in the most basic way we can. And again, derive this slope and y-intercept idea. Okay? So the equation for number 9, and you can tell just by looking at these two, that the equation is -4/5 xy equals -4/5. -2. Okay. Rather than just telling you, the slope is -4/5 and the y-intercept is -2, isn't that handy, isn't that easy? Okay. It's not very handy when you don't really understand what the slope is, or the y-intercept means, or that stuff. So we're going to go over the basics again. Here's the first most basic thing. You know, this graph is this picture, the shape. What is it made of? So this one is going to be a line, just like Kelly's a person. Like he's a person, he's got a body, but the body's not made of a body. What's it made of?
Blood.
Organs.
Molecules.
Cells.
Molecules.
Atoms.
Okay, I already said that.
Just so everybody's aware, the answer has been found. Let's all quiet down. Atoms is what everything's made of. Okay? There's all, it's as small as it gets, well, there's smaller things than atoms, or things inside of atoms, but atoms are very small. So we think of them as the building blocks of all the things. This desk, this table, the earth, you, your hair, your car, all those things are made of atoms. Now, this line is not made of a line. What's the line made of? What are its tiny little building blocks?
Points.
Okay, everybody here, 100%?
No.
Yeah.
Building blocks.
Points.
You did not say building blocks.
Points.
Points. He says made of points.
Yeah, that was the science teacher.
So if I were to look and see, here's my x-axis and my y-axis, and there's going to be a graph that appears. Let's use, not this graph, but just some random curvy thing, okay? Now this random curvy thing, well, first of all, it's not at all random. It's exactly as it should be, and it's made of points, okay? There's one, there's one, there's one, there's one. And when you draw enough points close enough together, we get the graph. So a graph is not simply a couple of points and a line that connects them, or a few points and a curve that goes through them. The line is the points. The curve is the points. Okay? The points make up the line. So when you raise your hand, like over to your desk, and you say, well, I can't really remember the slope. Is the slope like this, or is it like that? Is it up? Is it over? You should just stop asking those questions. You should go back to basics. If you can graph a graph for its basics, the answers of the slope and is it up, is it over, all that stuff is just follows from drawing the graph the most basic way that we can. Okay? So let's just see what the slope must be and what the y-intercept must be just by graphing these points. Okay? So now we're building onto it. A line or any graph is made of all these points. Now, where do I find these points? How do I find these points? Where do they come from? Somebody do? combine these points. That's where they get drawn. But how do I figure out which points I'm supposed to draw? Okay, you're kind of getting there. You just draw a point. That point is just a dot. It's just a thing. It's just a physical dot. Right? It's not numbers. Right? This point is not numbers. But there are numbers associated with this point. We derive the numbers from the point by where the point is. This point looks like it's about at 4.25 or something. 4.25. And it looks like the y is 7. Looks like x is 4.25 and y is about 7. Okay? So I get the two numbers from where the point is located. It's located right there. This equation has a graph. How do I turn this equation into a graph, into all of those points? How do I do it? Sydney? Times what? By what? -32 fifths that's -42 fifths. All right, now -42 fifths. What do you think about that number? Kind of gross. Right, it's -8 2/5. Okay, not horrible, but integers are nicer, right? Whole numbers. But perfectly valid and true solution. Let's put it on the graph. X is 8 and y is -8 2/5. 5, 6, 7, 8 2/5. Okay, there's the point right there. 8 2/5. So that point with its coordinates tells us that 8 for x and -8 2/5 for y is a solution to the equation. Can we find another solution? What about 0?
Like -4/5 times 0 minus
0. Okay, so you're saying let's let x be 0?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's watch that now. Y equals -4/5 times 0 minus 2, y equals negative 4 fifths times 0, what's that?
0.
0. 0 minus 2, what's 0 minus 2?
2.
Negative 2.
Negative 2, so another solution, 0, negative 2. X is 0, not over here, not over there. Negative 2. James. So x is 0, y is negative 2, x is 8, y is negative 8 and 2 fifths. Okay, these are two solutions we've found so far.
5.
What about 5?
Plug in for x.
Plug in 5 for x. So we've got like half a solution right now. Y equals negative 4 fifths times 5 over 1. Two. We'll just do this kind of the long way. We'll multiply these two fractions together. We get negative 20 over 5. That was a nice idea of Tyler's to use a 5 because now the numerator is divisible by 5. And so we have negative 20 divided by 5 is negative 4, minus 2, negative 6. All right. We found another solution. Let's find another solution.
10.
Okay. Negative 5.
Negative 5. I also heard a 10. Okay. Do you guys have any suggestions for more x? Let's pump it. Y equals negative 4 fifths times negative 5 over 1 minus 2. Here we get negative 4 times negative 5 is positive 20 over 5 minus 2. Y equals 4 minus 2, we get 2. Okay. All right, so we said 10, so y equals negative 4 fifths times 10 over 1 minus 2. Negative 40 over 5 minus 2, y equals negative 8 minus 2, negative 10, 10, negative 10. How long could we do this?
Forever.
I don't have forever though. Okay? And that's where the idea for a graph comes from. Like in the history of math, the idea for a graph comes from, I want to know all the solutions to this equation, but I don't have all of infinity to find them all. So I can look at a lot of them with a graph. Okay. So let's show on a graph the ones that we've found so far, and then we can use that graph to find more. All right. So 0, negative 2, 5, negative 6. 5, negative 6. Look at those 3 points. Now I have 3 points. Anything interesting about those 3 points?
They're in a line.
They're in a straight line. Now, that wouldn't be very likely that if I were to throw 3 points up there just randomly, you think it'd be very likely that they'd be in a straight line?
Not really.
Not randomly. If I were to just throw them up there randomly, it'd be really unlikely. Let me show you on the next page what it might look like if I threw up. Okay, so like I throw 3 darts up at the board. There's one that lands there. That one lands there. This one lands over there. Are they in a straight line?
No.
These three are not in a straight line together. And if I were to throw those 3 darts 1,000 times, maybe a couple of times, those 3 darts would be close to being in a straight line. But these three seem to be in a straight line. So it seems to be some kind of an order, some kind of a pattern arising here. 5, negative 6, negative 5, 2. Negative 5, positive 2, 10, negative 10. Now we have 5 points, and still it seems like, what? It seems like if we keep finding points from this equation, we'll just keep getting points in a straight line. I think if I were to try to find a point in this area, I would find that it's right around here, I bet there's a point right in here, that there's one here, that there's one over here. Do we all agree on that? Do you think that those points are part of this graph as well?
Yep.
And if I were to figure out exactly where those coordinates were, that would give me a new x and a new y, and that x and y should work in this equation. And that is what a graph is. And so if you're wondering, how do I graph this again? Okay, so you've forgotten the shortcut. That's okay. Just start plugging in some numbers for x and find some y's, find some solutions, and then plot those solutions. Right? And then look for yourself and see those patterns for yourself, the patterns being the y-intercept and the slope, okay? Find them for yourself again, right? Write them down in the margin of your paper and remind yourself, oh, now I just discovered or rediscovered that if I want to graph this equation or draw the graph of this equation, here's the little shortcut that I remembered again, right? So let's go ahead and draw a straight line and look at the pattern that you might notice from the points we've found so far. If my equation looks like this, as we've said quite a few times before, zero, if I plug in zero for x, I can see that y would have to be this bit right here. This constant right here. Because if zero is plugged in for x, this part goes away and all that's left is negative 2. So, negative 2. And that will help you to not make this mistake for this equation. Let's just clear all that out of there. If I have the same equation, here's a common mistake. Putting a point right there. Putting it on the x-axis as negative 2 instead of on the y-axis at negative 2. This person is making this mistake because they don't understand what graphs are. They're remembering that there's something about putting a point on one of the axes, either the x or the y, and they can't remember quite which one, at negative 2. They put it at negative 2. Okay. Are they going to make this mistake if they plug in a number for x and do all their math correctly and figure out exactly where that point is supposed to be? Much less likely that that's going to happen. We do the math, we plug in 0 for x, we're going to find that y is negative 2. And we're not going to make that mistake anymore, putting the point on the x-axis at negative 2. Okay, so I found that point, negative 2. And I can find all these points in between, but they all have either fractions for x or fractions for y, and I don't really want to deal with that. This point down here is nice, though, because it lands right on the grid. Okay? And that's where the idea for the slope comes from. I'm just trying to get a picture of this graph. I would like to find the next nice point, the point that lands right on the grid. And I notice that every nice point is, if I start at one of the points, over 5 and down 4 from the last nice point. And if I move over another 5 and down another 4, I find another nice point. If I go the other way, I go up four and back five, I find another nice point. I should be able to follow this pattern to another point. If I go up four and back another, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that pattern, right, it's in a straight line, so that next point should follow that same pattern. And this point's at negative 10, comma 6. So what does that tell me? There's a point at negative 10, 6. What does that tell me about the equation? Well, first we're assuming that the line is straight. And if I were to follow that pattern on that straight line and get to this point, right, this point would be on that line, negative 10, 6. If I go up 4, I go back into the 5, I should be at negative 10, 6. But what does negative 10, 6, this point being at negative 10, 6, tell me about this equation?
Pattern?
Well, we're following the pattern to find the point. Now we found the point. What does the point tell me about the equation? Say that point's at negative 10, 6. Why do I even say that? Why do I put those numbers to that point? Why do I assign those numbers to that point?
then I can figure out like how to get to the point. Like what the point how do you get to the point?
The coordinates of the point.
Coordinates.
Yeah. Because the negative 10, 6, those are the coordinates of the point. Okay, let's just break it down to negative 10. What does the negative 10 have to do with this point?
The x.
The x is negative 10. On the x-axis, like the coordinates, right? How to get to the point is part of the same. Go back 10, right? So the x part of the coordinate for this point is negative 10. X is negative 10. X part is negative 10. All right, what does the 6 tell me? The y value? Y.
Go up 6.
If I were to plot that point, I would have to go left 10 and up 6, and that's where the point is. But what does that tell me about the equations? Well, the negative 10, 6 tells you where the point is, but what does it tell you about the equation? What does it tell you about the equation?
That y is 6 and x is negative 10.
In this equation?
Yeah.
Slope. Doesn't tell you the slope. If x is negative 10 and y is 6, then it should work, is what it's telling you. Like, it should be equal. Let's see. We use the line to find like just a pattern of going up 4 and back 5 to find where that point is. So if y is 6 and x is 10, negative 4 times 10 is negative 40, 5 minus 2, negative 10, so this is positive 40. So 40 over 5 is 8 minus 2, and the result is it is balanced. Like the equation is the same on both sides. And it's confirmation that that is a solution to the equation. So the points that make up this graph, where they are, tells me the solutions to the equation. If you want to know where those points are, find solutions to the equation. Find x's and y's that work in this equation. And then you'll know the points. Once I plot those points, again, I can start to see the patterns. I have a y-intercept of negative 2, and I see a slope of down 4 to the right 5. Down 4 and to the right 5. Continues to, if I want to continue to find points forever and ever, I can always go down 4 to the right 5. And if you're not sure how to follow the slope to find the next point, graph it that way, then just plug in things for x. It's much more useful to remember that you can go back and plug numbers in for x and find the y than it is to remember the way to graph a line and the y-intercept and the slope. Because even if you remember right and you do it right 100% of the time, if you've forgotten the relationship between the graph and the equation, where the graph gives you solutions, the equation gives you solutions, and the solutions give you points on the graph, then knowing the y-intercept and the slope is only going to help you so much. Knowing that the equation gives you the graph can give you the y-intercept and the slope. So the same as I've just done here, I want you to do. I'm going to give you a couple of examples. Y equals 3/4 x plus 2, and another one. Y equals negative 4/7 x plus 1. Now, we can get the graph of this line by taking a shortcut, but a shortcut focusing on, a lot of you are focusing on too much, and you think like that is math. That is not math. Right? The math is the idea behind it. That is the idea of finding an x and a y and translating that into a point. Understanding that point represents those numbers come from this equation. So let's find a couple of numbers, an x and a y that work together. We've got a pair that works. Allie? Who's that?
Zero.
I need the pair. What pair of numbers works?
Zero and two.
Zero and two. Okay. Let's test it, see if it works. If y is two and x is zero, and let's see if it all works out. Well, 0 times 3 fourths is 0 plus 2. 0 plus 2 is 2. 2 equals 2. Allie must be right. She must have found a pair that you can call a solution because it solves the equation and makes the equation
That's
true.
Easy.
What's another pair?
4.
Damn.
0, 4.
0, 4?
Yeah.
No, 4,
2
5.
And 4?
No.
I don't know. I think
4, 5.
If
4, 5,
0, if we already. If 0 already gave us 2 for y, 0 probably won't give us also
yeah.
a 4.
I say 4 or 5.
Huh?
4 or 5.
It is.
All right, let's see about 4 or 5. 5 for y, 3 fourths times 4 over 1, plus 2. If we multiply straight across with fractions, 12 over 4, plus 2. 12 over 4 is 3, plus 2, and 5. Right, 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 equals 5.
One.
Since it came out to be the same on both sides,
it
must mean that Tally or any number of people who said 4 or 5 just a second ago must be correct. So 4 or 5 is another solution. If you're not sure what to do, and I ask you to graph a graph, just do this. I can throw you just a random mess of variables and exponents and multiplication, like y equals 2x squared minus 4x plus 3. And though that looks really complicated and crazy, okay,
no.
There's more to keep track of. It's a little trickier to do the calculations. But you can graph this graph. How would you go about graphing this graph?
Break it down.
How so?
Kind of like simplify it, kind of.
It's as simple as it can be.
Take stuff in for y and x.
Okay. We have to do that several times, right? You find several different points.
Right.
Good. We plug stuff in for x, and when we do the math, we'll know what y is.
Yeah.
Just do one real quick. Now, this graph is a lot different than a line. It's not a line. It's a curve, okay? And so we need a lot more points. For a line, you just need two. But for a curve, you're going to need a few more to get an idea of what this thing looks like. But for one thing, I can plug in 0 for x, right? That's a nice selection, because that'll be 0, right? 0 squared is 0, 10 2 is 0, this is 0, and all we're left with is?
Is 0.
Is 3. 3. Add 3 to all those zeros, you get 3. Okay? After that, 1's probably not going to be too bad.
Negative
2. 2 times 1 squared minus 4 times 1 plus 3. 1 squared is 1 times 2 is 2. Negative 4 times 1, that's negative 4, plus 3. 2 minus 4 is negative 2, plus 3 is 1. 1 and 1. We're not going to go any further with that. The point is, you don't have any idea about the shortcuts from graphing this graph. You don't know about, like, do I find the slope for this graph? The answer is no, I'm not going to find slope for this graph. This doesn't have a very useful slope. Actually, at every point has a different slope, okay? Slopes are for lines, and this is not a line. What are the shortcuts? Like, what's the fastest way to graph that? You have no idea. Can you still draw this graph?
Yeah, by plotting
a bunch of points, okay? If you're not sure what to do, if you're, like, saying to yourself, I can't remember the thing about the slope, and you always get it backwards or upside down or whatever, then just plug in something for x. Find the y. Now you have an x and a y, and that's what a graph is. It's just a bunch of points located at x and y, right? Have a good day.